Hi. Good evening, everyone. How are you guys doing today?
Yes.
Great. Can I hear it louder?
Yes.
Keep going, keep going.
Yes.
Further?
Yes.
Okay, great. Now we have some energy. Okay, it's time to channel your energy towards positive directions, towards growth, improvement, and laughter, of course. My name is Kush Saneja, introducing the session for today. So, I guess you all know we're all here to optimize instability, resilience. All these things matter a lot in today's world. I think we're really near the end of the COVID-19 year or so, and I think most of us have got our vaccination, had a really tough recent period, so it's good to really get our energy up, get our spirits up, get our immunity up, get our confidence up through a session like today, Mr. Saneja will be taking. To walk you through some research I've been doing recently, might be interesting to you. I've been reading a book called Emotional Intelligence. It actually finds that there's a scientific study in the 70s that correlates our immune system to our limbic system, which is your emotional system. So via the central nervous system, there's an actual link over there. So more you laugh, more you're positive, more you up your energy, the more better your immunity will actually be there. And that's been proved. That's scientifically been proved through an experiment involving rodents and involving chemicals that suppress your immune system. So these things are proven, and these things are really something that can help you and help me as well. So in order to benefit everyone around you as well as yourself, I urge you all to have 100 years worth of laughter inside him. As all of you probably know, he needs no introduction. So can I have your hands, not hands, your laughter to welcome Mr. Saneja.
India, and we will have our blessings song before we proceed further.
Haji, mummy ji, sunai de rahe hai? Start karo.
Mild exercises, so please stand up. Raise your hands, arms up, and move up and down. Energize your toes, energize your knees, energize yourself. Complete body energization. Up and down, 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 up and down. Into the right. Twist to the left. To the right. Twisting. To the right. Bend back and come back. Deep breathing. And exhale with a laughter. One more time. Give a movement to your arms. Inhale and up to the left. Inhale and up. Exhale and down. Left arm up. To the right. Inhale and up. Exhale and down. Arms parallel to the ground. Twist to the left. Now this, all the sessions I want to be interactive, so I'll not speak much, I'll ask only questions. You people have to speak.
Okay, next slide.
Why do we get angry?
Boliye, this table thing.
Why do we get angry?
Because
of others' fault. Others' fault, because of others' fault. Why do we get angry?
Why do I get angry?
Because
somebody irritates me.
Somebody is irritating. Why do we get angry?
What
you
think does not happen.
Why do you get angry?
Having more stress.
You get angry. Why do we get angry?
Somebody scolds me without any reason.
You mean your wife?
No.
Okay. Why do we get angry?
Happen the way I want it. Something happened to you, that's why I get angry.
Okay. So you get angry because things sometimes happen not the way you want, they happen. So where is the adjustment required? The adjustment is required here. Because you can't control what is happening. You go in a nice mood, you enter some place, and suddenly somebody starts something which irritates you. So you can't help that because that's going to happen. But you can help yourself by respond. How do you respond? How do you respond is what is in your control. So let's see some of the things, how we can improve our responses. Once we understand, last slide, completely. Consequences of anger are generally more painful than the reasons. So if we understand what are the consequences of anger, and we'll find they are generally more painful than the reason of the anger. So then once you have this, you will be able to
control your anger.
Anger is like catching fire in your hand and throwing on others. So if you catch fire, one thing definite, that your hand will burn. When you throw on others, depends how the other person responds. He may also get burnt or he may not get burnt, because it depends on the response of the other person. But for sure you will get burned because you are catching the fire in your hand. So never try not to catch fire in your hand. Now don't play with the fire. I hope my wife is also listening. Anger is like eating poison and assuming others will suffer. So it's a very false assumption. When you are angry, you are eating poison for sure. But you feel that others will suffer, which possibly may or may not. Others may suffer or may not, depending how they respond. But for sure, you will be suffering because you are eating the poison. Which all of us are familiar, that in relationship, again it's ego basically. Again it boils down to ego hurts. So if we can control our ego part, if we can be aware of our ego part, when we are having the ego, if we are aware of that, control that, we can avoid loss of material possessions. And many times we feel angry because we are always clinging, attracted, attached to the materials. So when we lose materials, we immediately feel angry. So all this realization that the consequences of anger are far painful than the anger itself. Or consequences of anger, consequences are less painful than the anger itself. If we deeply realize that, then you will never feel angry. Because when you see that whatever material loss is there, it can be recovered. The material loss can be recovered. But angry, you lose your health, you lose your well-being, you lose your relationship. That's much more difficult to recover. So if we understand all these reasons, we will be able to become more aware about it. And then we will be able to do the next. Next. Consequences of anger: physical health damage leading to blood pressure, sugar, cholesterol, arthritis. So anger, when you are angry, remain aware you are attracting these one by one. So once you are aware that you are attracting all this one by one, you will start controlling your anger, you will start detaching yourself with the circumstances, and you will start doing what is not required for opportunities. Loss of opportunities. depression,
loss of appetite. So all these things lead to one another. Loss of appetite lead to stomach upset leads to ulcer, ulcer leads to other problems in the body like cholesterol, BP. They're all interlinked with each other, and everything starts with the turbulence in the mind. So if they say there are only two type of diseases in the world, one that starts from here and the other that starts from here. 50%, 50%. If you can control your digestion, if you can control your mind, you are the most healthiest person.
So depression, loss of appetite, loss of opportunities, failure, all these are the consequences of the anger.
So once we realize these consequences, we can start controlling ourselves. We can do a better job for ourselves.
Techniques to avoid anger, emotions.
When you start watching your own emotions, that is called something like self-realizations. Once you start watching your own emotions, you will be able to control yourself better. Become aware when anger is coming or happening. Be mindful of your emotions. Be mindful means being in the present. You will start watching your emotions. Then you will start learning when the anger is just starting, just beginning. You will be able to understand that, oh, anger is coming in my emotions. Then you will be able to control it, you will be able to cool it down. So the best technique of anger is when the anger starts building up, you start laughing. Time to laugh! Deep breathing, cooling pranayams, alom vilom. These pranayams which we have done, especially the alom vilom pranayam and deep breathing, they help a lot for anger management. And the other one is cooling pranayam, which we can now do the cooling pranayam. Cooling pranayam is clench the teeth, inhale between the teeth and exhale from the nostril. This is called cooling pranayam. So let's do it. This helps to control the anger. This cools down your body. This cools down your mind. Everybody understood? Yes. So when your mother starts scolding you, ask her to do this pranayama. Okay? Clear? Eh? Whenever she scolds you, ask her to do this cooling pranayama.
Cooling pranayama.
Cooling pranayama. Okay?
Otherwise, those situations are problems.
So many times we have problem situations. Every day we have problem situations. People who are in business, they have one set of problems. People who are in job, they have another set of problems. People who are married, they have one set of... People who are not married, they have one set of problems. People who are married, they have problems and problems. So there are always problems. So we have to always overcome those problems by this situation that we become aware of that. Awareful of mind can convert situations into opportunities. Otherwise, those situations become problems. So we have to start learning that through the laughing, through the cool mind, through the calm mind, we convert those problems into opportunities. We convert those problems into much better situations. So we are able to improve our situations. Good. Time to laugh. Okay, throw the ball. Where was the ball? Yeah, throw it. First person in black, Jenny. Okay, laughter benefit.
Laughter benefits is...
Show your face on that side. Laughter benefits loudly.
Boost our immune system.
Laughter immunes our immune system. Let's laugh! Okay, we go to the next. Does everybody get sound sleep? Those who get disturbed sleeps, raise your hands. Okay. Okay, first is, why do we need sleep? Why do we need sleep?
To
To get more energy. Yes. Why do we need sleep?
So that we feel great the next day.
To feel great the next day. Why do we need?
To wake up fresh.
To wake up fresh. Why do we need sleep?
Regenerate the energy.
To regenerate our body, mind and soul. Why do we need sleep?
To recharge the body again.
To recharge the body.
To rescue our hormones and other stuff.
To rescue our hormones and other, refresh ourselves and make ourselves fresh, healthy, recuperate and recharge. So this is why we need the sleep. Sleep is our natural repairing mechanism. When we get sound sleep, we get fresh and rejuvenated. So when we get sound sleep, we get fresh and rejuvenated. Sleep is governed by a gland which is called pineal gland. Pineal gland is, this is called third eye. Just behind the third eye, right in the center of the brain, there is a pineal gland. Behind the third eye, right in the center of the brain, there is a pineal gland. And this pineal gland is the secretion of endocrine gland found in vertebrates. That is the source of melatonin, a hormone that plays a central role in the regulation of natural rhythms. You know, nature has rhythms. Every 3 to 4 hours, the nature's rhythm changes. And if you are in tune with the natural rhythms, your sleep, your digestion, your all your function, excretion, toxin, all the function will fall in place and they will be at their optimum energy if you are doing the things in line with the nature's rhythm. So nature's rhythm, that roughly 24-hour cycle of biological activities associated with nature's periods of light and darkness. Melatonin hormone is a sleep-inducing hormone. Good secretion of this hormone leads to sound sleep. So your sleep is all governed by a hormone called melatonin hormone. And this I have prepared based on my own experience because... videos into this, that how to recover the sleep patterns, how to become a natural sleep patterns. And then I realized few things, I experimented on myself and then my sleep started improving and with the grace of God, now I get a very good sound sleep. Time to laugh! Laughter benefit.
Makes you younger.
Laughter makes you younger. Keep yourself growing younger. Okay. So one of the reasons where you can improve the secretion of melatonin juices is through the laughter. That's what we are doing. This is one of the main things that can help you in improvement in the secretion of the melatonin hormones. The next few things which helps in the secretion of the melatonin hormones is exercise, relaxing music. In the evening, if you hear relaxing music instead of the news or horror movies or complicated serials, you will have wonderful sleep. Yoga, pranayam, they help in the sleep. Swimming or walk. Again, this is my own experience that when I have a disturbing day, I go straight into the swimming pool and after that I have dinner and after dinner I'm so sleepy. Swimming helps a lot in the swimming and in long walks. A long walks helps a lot. Om chanting. With the Om chanting, you can clear your mind. You can clear all the stray thoughts. You can clear everything from your mind with Om chanting. So your mind becomes clear, your thoughts reduce the level of the thoughts, slowly and slowly you will fall into sleep. This helps a lot. So these are the all 5 to 10 minutes of Om chanting and you will fall asleep. So just before you go to the bed, start doing, you know, these are very nice YouTube videos available on Om chanting. So along with that video, you start chanting Om and you will fall asleep very easily. Simple meditation, breathing. Breathing helps a lot and breathing is the best when you are doing a belly breathing. So let's see what is belly breathing. Belly breathing is when you start breathing from your stomach, fill up the stomach, fill up the lungs, inhale and then exhale from the nostril. So let's practice belly breathing. So So consciously first swimmer, the lower lungs, which is near your stomach area, tummy area, is your lower part of the lungs. Then the middle parts of the lung, then upper parts of the lung, and then exhale. So let's do three times again. Now what you can do is,
please can you repeat this thing, instruction, how to start, how to do this?
Okay, when consciously when you're breathing, first you let your belly bulge out, then the stomach filling, then the upper part, and exhaling also you make a little, when your tongue is touching your jaws, you will have a little bit of sound while exhaling, and that sound also you can watch with your mind, that sound while exhaling, and that also controls the mind and helps in sleeping. And this is a very tried and tested method by me. The moment you go to the bed, do first 10 minutes om chanting, then you start doing the belly breathing, you will have a wonderful and deep sleep. So let's do it again. And I think, I don't know whether you're able to hear the sound with this, which I'm doing. Okay, now I'm moving. So when while exhaling, your tongue is touching the lower jaws, then you will create a little bit of sound, and that sound helps in controlling the mind. Let's do it one more time. Very helpful for deep sleep, and you can use it repeatedly. Always sleep and get up at the same time, even on weekends. Ideal time as per yoga and science of Ayurveda, your eyes, why you get something on the eyes in the morning is detoxification. You start going for toilet, you start going for pee and poo, because of all this excretion mechanism, toxin removing mechanism works. And they work at their optimum when you have a sleep between 9 p.m. to 3 p.m. Okay, if ideal is not possible, then go near the ideal. And the near the ideal is 9 to 11 p.m. go to sleep. Never go beyond 11. Ideal is 9 p.m. Next ideal is 10 p.m. If not 10, extreme is 11. Never be after that. Getting up 3 a.m. is the ideal. If you can't manage to get up at 3 a.m., 4 a.m., 5 a.m. But never beyond 5 a.m. So those who can now wake up tomorrow before 5 a.m., raise your hands. 1, 2, 3, 4. From this table, anybody can wake up tomorrow before 5 a.m. every day. Okay, good. From this table, anybody can wake up before 5 a.m. Good. From that, wake up 5 a.m. or before from tomorrow. From tomorrow onwards, this commitment is tomorrow onwards, not only tomorrow. Correct? Agree? Raise your hand. Agree? Agree? We can wake up before 5 a.m. Okay, good. Well done.
We trust it.
Trust for the person, huh? Okay. Now, afternoon sleep, many people ask me this question, is it good or not? A small nap in the afternoon is always recharging, rejuvenating. So 20-25 minute nap is okay, but a long sleep is not good, because if you take long sleep in the afternoon, then you don't get the sleep at night properly. Then you can't sleep at 9, 9:30, 10, then the sleep naturally comes later on. So a small nap in the afternoon is fine, but after that it should be. Now, what are the foods with help? These are the foods, those who have sleep disturbance or sleep problems, these are the foods they should increase. If you increase these foods in your intake daily, your sleep will start improving, because these foods help in secretion of melatonin hormones. Once your melatonin hormones are in control, you will always get a better. Banana, ashwagandha, milk and honey, buttermilk, lemon, whole grain wheat, almonds, broccoli, apples, blueberries, avocados. These are the best for the secretion of melatonin juices. Food should always be consumed 3 hours before the sleep. 3 hours or more before the sleep. People have been able to point out the mistake.
Number
I'm going to put juice in there.
Good, good. Excellent observation. Let's give him a big laughter. Excellent observation. Excellent observation. हाँ सुषमा देवी का पाउडर मिलता है अलादीन में मोबाइल में है ओके
the eye exercise
is helping very good excellent
give me big laughter
This has been a unique finding by myself that sun gazing helps a lot in the secretion of the melatonin hormones. Gazing sun 15 to 30 minutes before sunset, exposure of the body to the sun up to 2 hours after sunrise or up to 2 hours before sunset. Sun is also an excellent source of vitamin D. So those if you have any disturbance in the sleep, they should do sun gazing in the evening just before the sunset. When the sun is orange in the morning or when the sun is orange in the evening, that is the time to do sun gazing. Look at the sun. Again, those who start sun gazing, it is always increasing progressively. Don't do very long in the first day, 1 minute, second day, 2 minutes, third day, 3 minutes, fourth day, 4 minutes. Like that, you can go up to 15 minutes. And after that, you can do every day 15 minutes. But reach 15 minutes in 15 days. And after that, you can do every single day 15 minutes. Not only sleep, this will improve your eyesight. This will improve vitamin D. And you all know what are the benefits of vitamin D. I don't need to repeat that. Vitamin D is very, very important for our body because it helps in absorption of so many other minerals and helps the growth of the bones, strength of the bone, and all those benefits which you all know. So this is a very good technique which those who are not doing, they can implement from tomorrow in your life and you will find wonderful things happening with your body and mind. Sleeping area. Sleeping room should be as dark as possible to induce secretion of melatonin juices. So a dark room is always good because the pineal gland becomes more active when the room is dark. And the secretion of the melatonin hormones becomes better. It should be as airy as possible, temperature between 18 to 26 degrees, the cooler the better. Sleep after warm water bath, when the body temperature drops, it induces sleep. A warm water bath is very good for sleep. Not only that, water bath is excellent before this in the evening because it takes out all, not only the physical cleaning, but spiritual cleaning, mental cleaning. All the negativity goes out of the body. You feel very fresh after the bath. It's not only the physical cleaning which happens. A lot of things in your mind also happen when you take a nice warm water bath. Bath in the morning should be always cold water, chilled water if possible, because that rejuvenates the body, improves the circulation in the body, improves the blood circulation in the body. The moment you put cold water, the body reacts. The reaction of the body improves the circulation of the blood. And that improvement in the circulation of blood gives you freshness throughout the day. If you take a cold water bath in the morning, you will always find full day you will feel very fresh. And the reason is the morning the body has reacted to the cold water and that energy keeps circulating throughout the day. So morning should be always cold water bath or chilled water bath if possible. And evening should be always warm water, lukewarm water bath, to shed all the negative energies, relax the mind, relax the muscles, relax the body, and it helps a lot. Bed and room should be neat and clean, pillow height to suit your habits, mattress comfortable. And if you want more darkness in the area, you can cover eyes with black fabric to create more darkness and thus induce the sleep. So these are some of the things which you can incorporate to get a better sleep in your life. Left side is the best to sleep. Left side stimulates pingala nadi that perhaps helps in quick digestion of food and your repair mechanism works at its best. Are you aware that you have alternate nostril patterns? Sometimes your right nostril is more dominant, sometimes your left nostril is more dominant. So that dominance keeps changing every 2 to 3 hours. When your right nostril is more dominant, your pinglana nadi is more dominant, you get more warmth in the body, food digestion becomes improved. When you sleep on the left side, your right nostril becomes more dominant. When it is more dominant, it helps in digestion of the food. When the food gets digested in the beginning of the sleep itself, the repair mechanism works at its optimum. Because the heavy food intake or the presence of too much food and indigested food leads to a disturbed sleep and disturbed repairing mechanism. So for a perfect repairing mechanism, start sleeping on the left side. Once you get sleep, the body will turn left, right on its own, depending on the needs, whether it needs more warmth or whether it needs more coolness. So Ida and Pinglana Nadis keep changing themselves during the sleep. But to start, initiate, we should sleep on the left side to get a warmth through the right nostril, quick digestion of the food, and you get a good sleep. It stimulates Pinglana Nadi that helps in quick digestion of food and repair mechanism works at its best.
Can I have a question here?
Sure, sir.
Suppose you are sleeping in the left side, so your stomach, the food which is remaining, it goes in the left side.
And left side?
So
yeah.
How the food will absorb, I mean how the food will move if you are not sleeping to the right side?
Okay, if you...
I mean the food has not moved down.
No. I don't have at the moment slide of the stomach. In the stomach also, there is a supporting mechanism of the food. And when you sleep on the left side of the stomach is more stronger to support the weight of the food or the digestion process of the food. Once we will, again, during the interval, we'll show you that slide, we'll make a slide. The whole mechanism of our stomach is to support the food when you're on the left side, because there is a supporting mechanism in the left side of the food. When you sleep on the right, you can experiment tonight itself, that if you sleep on the right side after the food, you feel a lot of heaviness and a lot of discomfort. When you sleep on the left side after the food, you will feel much more comfortable because the whole physical mechanism of the stomach is also designed to sleep.
Let's hear the laughter benefit.
Okay, time to laugh. throw the ball.
Coach.
Yes, coach. Laughter benefit.
Makes you happy.
Laughter makes you happy. Okay, good. These are some of the things which again helps in sleep. Pure conscious and clarity of mind is the best sleeping pill.
Excuse me.
One question.
Sure.
Can we sleep on our stomach?
Can we sleep on our stomach? You can sleep anywhere, it's okay. Stomach, on the back. What we are discussing is, what is the optimum benefit? Optimum is when you sleep on the left. If you, less than optimum is sleep any other way, whichever way we are comfortable. If you sleep on the right, you will also good. If you sleep on the stomach, is also good. If you sleep on the back like this, is also good. All are good. But what we are discussing, what is the optimum way of getting a good sleep and digesting our food and stimulating our repair mechanism. Otherwise, all are okay. And as I said, in the beginning you sleep on the left. After that, your own body and mind signals take care. Sometime you will be on stomach, sometime you will be on right, topsy-turvy, sometime you will find that your blanket is gone right, your arms are gone left, sometimes you are hitting somebody, sometimes somebody is hitting you. So all this keeps happening. What we are saying is how to initiate your sleep. Yes, any other?
So that your heart is on the left side, up, not pressing the heart down below. So I do not know which one is correct.
Well, we can do a little more study, but I have studied that sleeping, initiate on the left is always good.
Left is always good.
Left is always good. Yep. Okay, good karmas, pure conscious and clarity of mind is the best sleeping pill. So a lot of people go for sleeping pills. So this is the best sleeping pill that you can have in your life, rather than going to a pharmacy. Apply this sleeping pill. Pure conscious, clarity of mind is the best sleeping thing. Review your karmas before sleep.
to feel relaxed and fulfilled to get good sleep. Ensure throughout the day that quality of karma is excellent. So for a deep sleep, this is the mantra. All other things are accessories, support functions. But core mantra is this. This is the core mantra of a deep sleep. All other what we are discussing is the support functions. So if you focus on these, you will always have a good sleep because you have clarity of mind, pure consciousness, and you are fulfilled from inside that you have done something good for the society during the day. These are the don'ts. Blue light of TV, laptop, mobile is the enemy of pineal gland. So they constrict the pineal gland, they constrict the flow of the hormones. So refrain watching TV, mobile at night time, at least 2 hours before sleep. बड़ा मुश्किल है, बहुत मुश्किल है, कह रहा हूँ बहुत मुश्किल है. Emotions, fear, worry. Avoid seeing horror movies or complicated TV shows. Stimulate from TV series, shrink pineal gland. Interrupts the secretion of the melatonin. So is it possible or is it impossible to do?
Possible.
Impossible. You know what is impossible? What is the spelling of impossible?
I-M-P-O-S-S-I-B-L-E.
Okay, so first you take I separate, then M separate, then it becomes possible. I am possible. Understood?
Yes.
So first you take out I from that, then you take out M from that, then you take out possible. So what it becomes?
I am possible.
I am possible. Give him a big hand. I am possible. Good, well done.
There's one more point I want to add. Nowadays, every Android or every iPhone has a function of like eye care function. If we turn that on, it cuts off very much of blue light. So at least we can do that option, that thing.
Is it in settings? In settings?
Yeah, you have to check which brand you are following and how you are like how you can turn on that eye care.
Is it an app or it is just an automatic function?
Inbuilt feature.
It is
a setting.
It is in the settings. Yeah.
Setting. Just output
it
and just close the blue light.
What is it called?
Just close the blue light.
Like
okay, good idea.
Yeah.
So he's added a nice point that if you go to the settings of your phone, there is a blue eye cutoff feature available, so use that and your sleep quality will improve, definitely.
Which is a blue eye?
It's a blue cut mode, eye care mode, different names in different brands.
Night shift. For iPhone, it's night shift.
These are some of the things we should avoid again for a good sleep. Avoid tea, coffee and other stimulants like alcohol. Alcohol is sedative but it prevents deep sleep by interrupting rapid eye movement. So tea and coffee are stimulant. So you have an option of juice and water available outside. And alcohol, normally we say, oh, take red wine and you will have a nice sleep. Or take a beer if you are not getting the sleep. Which is to some extent true, that if your totally sleep is disturbed, then you these things support the sleep. But they give you only a shallow sleep. They prevent the rapid eye movement. So alcohol can give us temporary solution, a temporary relief to get few hours of sleep if you are totally disturbed and you are not getting sleep. But it is not a permanent solution, and never make it a permanent solution because it has so many other side effects. Once in a while, if it is a temporary solution, temporary relief required. But since it prevents rapid eye movement, you never get a deep sleep on that. Time to laugh! give on the front.
Mariam's son.
Okay, take this part. Okay, speak one laughter benefit.
I am possible.
Okay, speak anything.
Laughter makes your cheek muscles active.
Very good. Laughter makes your cheek muscles active. Let's activate our cheek muscles. Activate your cheek muscles. Okay. Before we go to this topic, I have one guest who is an expert on naturopathy. I'll invite Anthony D'Souza to come to the stage. Yes, Anthony.
Hi.
Laughter evening.
And laughter evening.
Anthony and me, we met how many years before?
About 25 years before. And this is in Rashidiya, Nalgutem Training Center, where Mr. Sunetra was conducting a small workshop like this one. And as he was talking about the yoga, he said, oh my goodness, if you attend yoga, there will be so many benefits. I said, what benefit? If you have any ailment, if any disease, you can get rid of it. I said, oh, is that so powerful? Why don't I join? The next morning, I went to Buhara College and started yoga. From that time to now, I'm still doing yoga and I can experience myself how good yoga is.
And now I tell you, that time I asked him, what is your age? He said me 46 years. And I told him, you will keep growing younger, and today is 71 years and he's much younger than what he was that time. He's 71 years old. He's celebrating his 71st birthday in this month. And that is 25 years before. And he has been the far best example I ever had in my classes. A follower of yoga full day and every single day. A follower of naturopathy, food discipline, all type of disciplines built into him. So I invited him that you come to my workshop today and share your experiences of last 25 years of yoga and naturopathy experience. And now he promotes naturopathy in a big way in the society. Yes, Anthony, your stage.
So, good evening, everybody. Good evening.
Good evening.
You heard about the naturopathy, anybody? You heard about naturopathy?
Yes.
Wonderful. Great. According to my experience, naturopathy is the best way to live a healthy life. I have a tremendous experience how naturopathy works. You are what you eat. If you eat a junk food, you become a junk person. In stuff and all these things, you will become a chemical person. But if you eat the right food, if you eat the food which is grown on trees, if you eat the live food, you know, live food which has a life in it, you will become one of the healthiest person in this planet.
I just want to repeat, if you eat junk food, you become a junk box.
Junk box.
If you eat preserved food, you become a chemical box. And if you eat natural food, you keep growing younger.
Thank you. So, if you follow naturopathy, you can live a life, full-fledged life. What do you mean full-fledged life? Full-fledged life is 120 years in this planet without taking any medicines or tablet.
And let me repeat, his mission, his motto and his tagline in all the workshops that he conducts on naturopathy is, live with me 120 years healthy and happy. Live with me 120 years healthy and happy. That is his tagline mission in all the workshops. He also conducts a lot of workshops on naturopathy. So that is his tagline.
So, what happened? When we eat the live food, it automatics give you boost in your body to make you more active. When you are active, you know, your blood circulation improves. When your blood circulation improves, your digestive system is becomes smooth. And as soon as digestive system becomes smooth, your energy, your whole being becomes so good that you will definitely live 120 years, and that is what I'm going to do it. Even though, you know, I when I go to Goa, I'm from Goa, and I sometimes visit my classmates. Some of them are not there in the world. Some of them who are there, they are having a problem with arthritis and rheumatism and all these things. And I was asking them, why? What's the problem? You and I are the same age. The problem is that they take chemicals, too much chemicals, which has a side effect. So, by the grace of God, by the nature, I did not take a single tablet for the last 12 years, 8 months past.
How many years?
12 years, 8 months past. I did not take one single tablet. I simply go with the nature, how the nature works. Now, I'll give you a small example. If you take ash gourd, you know ash gourd? I forgot to get actually the fruit. Ash gourd, or we call it winter melon. You know ash gourd?
Sahil, can you show ash gourd?
Ash gourd juice. If you drink ash gourd juice from empty stomach, if you drink ash gourd juice empty stomach early in the morning every day, I guarantee you, all your ailments will disappear. All this, whatever you have, and that is I did it myself. Now, if you go and take me to the doctor and examine, I'm sure there is no any ailment in my body. So it's a powerful ash gourd which makes you, you know, energetic your body. So I request you to take ash gourd juice, experiment how it works.
Every day I'm taking.
You're taking, very good. Anybody else who is taking ash gourd?
I'm taking every day.
Oh, wonderful, great.
Very good.
Here is ash gourd.
Now he is guaranteeing you 120 years at the
It really works. You have to experiment and see how it works. Amazing, amazing result. Because I have been doing this for a lot of many years. Now I did not, because my body is already set up. So it is so good. You must experiment and see how the body works. So, suppose you take a wrong food, your body will give you a sort of signal.
Time to laugh. Throw the ball. Where is the ball?
Okay. Okay, what is the benefit?
Laughter benefit.
Laughter benefit release the mind and more lungs in happiness.
No, release your, relax your mind and lungs become more powerful and happy.
If you take a wrong food, your body will give you a signal, oh, there is something wrong. So take action. If you take action with your body, mind, emotion, and your energy, you will be again the healthiest person in this planet. So most of the people do not understand the chemistry of the body. You don't have to go to a specialist, why my body is something wrong, no. You yourself can be a doctor. You can experiment yourself why it is not happening. If you can experiment your body, example, if you eat some food, for instance, like you eat some food and you don't find active, you feel like, oh, lazy. That means that food is not working for you. So something which works for you, something, when you eat some food, it makes you active. You see, so that food, adopt that sort of food. It's a simple experiment. You can make yourself a doctor and see how it works. You don't have to go to the specialist. Simply adopt the what food you eat, and according to that, adopt that food. Okay, now, ash good, as I said, it's amazing, means amazing. Again, there is another food which has a groundnuts. It's like here, groundnuts. Oh, there again, there's a thing. Groundnuts here, groundnuts.
Yeah.
It has so many vitamins on it. If you can do one thing, simple thing. Soak this one handful of groundnuts in a water for 12 hours and put one banana in it, grind it, and you can put a little bit of honey. It's amazing, means amazing, because I drink this one. It's so many benefits in this ash, groundnuts with a little bit of honey, with banana, grind it and have it. You will find it amazing results. Program about this naturopathy. So if you can adopt naturopathy, it will be a wonderful journey, short journey. You can make it Sadhguru, you know. What he says? He says that if your body is pleasant, we call it health. If your body is more pleasant, we call it pleasure. If your mind is pleasant, we call it peace. If your mind is more pleasant, we call it joy. If your emotions are pleasant, we call it love. If your emotions are more pleasant, we call it compassion. If your energy is pleasant, we call it blissful. If your energy is more pleasant, we call it ecstasy. If everything is pleasant, yoga means union. If we all have a good united, we can be the wonderful people in this world. Thank you.
Well done. Give him a big hand. Really, laughter benefit.
Laughter benefit.
Your face glows and you become handsome.
You become glowing and face becomes a glowing face. Well done, Anthony. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. So everybody has water on the table?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Keep drinking. Because water therapy says keep drinking water.
Yes.
Cosmos, five elements. Cosmos is made up of five elements: fire, earth, water, air, ether. Control these five elements and optimize your energy and health. And we have three kind of tendencies: Pitta, Vata, and Kapha. So our human body is also made of five elements. The whole universe is made of five elements, and we are part of the same universe. 60-70% of our body and 75% of child body is water. We can't survive without water for more than a couple of days. Water is spread over kidneys, liver, brain, lungs, body cells, and even bones are lubricated with water. The brain and the heart are composed of 73% water, and the lungs are about 83% water. The skin contains 64% water. Muscle and kidneys are 79% water, and even the bones are watery with 31%. So all parts of our body are water, water, and water. A different percentage in different parts of the body, but very important that every single part of the body has a water. So if we control the water element, we are controlling it, this one of the most important of these five elements. The basic cause of dehydration or not taking enough water, losing too much water, or a combination of both. Constipation, headaches, skin problems, pimples, hair fall, digestive problems, and reduced functioning of the mental faculties, weakness, sleepiness, increase in weight. So if you're not drinking enough water, this is what can happen in your life. So always drink enough water to avoid these problems. Even your mental faculties are directly linked with the hydration. Your body is directly linked with the hydration. They say oxygenate, hydrate and lubricate. This is a mantra of keeping your body in the right shape. Oxygenate, hydrate and lubricate. Lubricate means massage, oil massage. So this is the mantra of keeping your body into the right shape.
At least you know this 7 to 8 liters.
7 to 8 liters a day.
8 glasses of water. 4 liters.
4 liters a day. Good.
3 liters minimum when you are inside. When you are outside, minimum 5 liters to drink.
3 liters when you are inside, 5 liters when you are in the open.
3 liters, sir.
3 liters. 3 to 4 liters.
As per body requirement.
As per your body requirement.
As per your body. 4 to 5 liters. As per your body.
4 to 5 liters.
Yeah, 12 cups a day.
12 cups a day. Okay. So these are different answers how much you drink. So let's see. Next. Depends on the season and activity, but generally 2.5 to 4 liter a day is minimum required. When you are inside AC area, 2.5, 3, 4 liter. When you are outside, 4 and up. When you are in the sun, air, doing a labor work or doing some hard work outside, yes, 4 liter and above. So it depends on the needs of the person.
Clear urine is hydrated. A yellow urine is dehydrated. Now these are some of the things which you can do. Extremely dehydrated, drink a large bottle of water. Dehydrated, drink 2 to 3 glasses. Mild hydrated, drink a large glass of water. Hydrated, you are drinking enough, keep it up. These can be this chart can be put in your house, in the toilets, in the office toilets, in the site toilets, so that everybody while urinating can understand where do they stand on the dehydration or hydration and immediately take the quick actions to recover. I have already seen in many of the sites in Dubai this chart is available in all the toilets, but not all the sites. So this is a very good chart to keep in the sites or house toilet or office toilets, so that all the people using the toilet, they can immediately make out whether they need some more extra water or they are okay with the water. Drink your solids and eat your fruits.
Like water, you have to
sip
by eating like that.
Okay, so please explain what is the meaning of that.
That means water the fluids, you should not drink once one hour. Sip by sip, you have to take the water. Like
okay, now first is drink your solids. What does it mean?
The water the once one hour, you have to eat like that. That's like
so once you drink your. Yes, anybody likes to explain? Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So when we are eating, we don't eat whole plate at once. We'll eat little by little. So same thing you have to do with this thing. We have fluids. That is, eat fluids means you have to take little by little. And. That's what I understood.
It is not recommended while
you eat. So when you are drinking solid, you are chewing so much that you make it liquid, and then that is called drinking the solid. You chew it. Your saliva energy is very strong alkaline energy, which helps a lot in the digestion and which helps a lot in the improvement of your health. So always chew so much your food that you drink your solids. And when you are drinking water, take sip by sip, mix with saliva, and then take it inside, and that is called eat your fruits. So eat your fruits and drink your solids. So whenever next step you are now drinking, always eat your fruits. And when you are having a small snacks after this, drink that time. Take water sip by sip like wine. Take all saliva inside with water, the pH value will always be good. Saliva is very alkaline, and especially the first saliva in the morning after the good night's sleep is the most alkaline. So drinking water in the morning before brushing the teeth, before doing anything, your morning saliva should go inside you when you are drinking the water in the morning. Drink 200 ml to 250 ml at a time for good absorption. Don't drink too much water at a time. Drink 1 glass at a time
then give a gap, then give another glass, so that water gets fully absorbed. It gets totally absorbed. Always drink water in sitting posture, never in the standing posture. So always drink with a calm and cool mind in a sitting posture, and don't gulp the water. Sip by sip in a sitting posture, mindful be about it, and take about sip by sip. When to drink? Drinking warm water 2 to 4 glasses in the morning is excellent for cleansing your digestive organs and blood. You may add honey, lemon, turmeric powder, cinnamon for making it more effective. Morning means immediately after getting up, so the time
it's
that
time
morning.
To laugh.
Time to laugh. Now throw the ball next. Throw the ball. After ball bang na. दोनों का हो गया, इनका हो गया, किसी और नए नए व्यक्ति के पास पहुंच गया जिसका नहीं हुआ अभी तक. या द लाफ्टर बेनिफिट.
इट विल मेक यू मोर सेक्सी.
इट विल मेक यू मोर सेक्सी. 42. नेवर ड्रिंक कोल्ड फ्रिज वाटर एंड आइस वाटर एज दे आर वेरी हार्मफुल. Lukewarm water is very beneficial. You know that Japanese have the best health in the world, long life in the world, long average in the world. And what is their mantra?
Hot water.
Hot water, warm water throughout the day. Throughout the day, they keep drinking warm water or warm tea, herbal tea or herbal tea. So, something we can really learn that throughout the day, warm water or herbal tea throughout the day. Improve quality prana energy of water by keeping 12 hours in bronze container or earthen pots. So this is from the science of Ayurveda, that 1 hour by drinking solar water. Very easy to implement, but solar always do in this kind of bottles, glass bottle, never put a plastic bottle. In fact, plastic is a killer. Plastic bottles should not be used at all. So always use this kind of bottles. You put it for 24 hours, 12 hours in the sun, and then drink that water. So normally one day you keep it and then next day you drink that water. That's very good. And while doing the solar, also see that there is no plastic component. For example, if there is an inside plastic component, then you don't use these caps. You can just put a tissue box, tissue paper on this. There should not be any plastic element in the cap when you put it up for the solar, because that otherwise creates problem. So if it is totally metallic, then it's okay. Otherwise, put just a tissue paper on this to cover it. You can always improve quality of keeping 12 hours under the sun and make it solar. Always drink water with higher pH value. These days, some of the manufacturers, they give pH value on the water. So those with higher pH value is good. You can choose that.
Alkaline water.
Alkaline water or higher pH value, same as alkaline water. No, I'm not a brand ambassador for any manufacturer, so I'll not name any manufacturer. Next slide is showing that. So the optimal pH value is 7.35 in our body. That's when you keep it around 7.35 or little higher, your body functions at its best. Your healing mechanism, pH value and alkalineness has a lot to do with your healing mechanism, with your rejuvenating mechanism, with your repairing mechanism. Repair mechanism is functioning very well. So Anthony must be having 8 pH value. Yeah, so if the pH value is low, you are more acidic, and acidity means a lot of problems, inflammations, and ulcers and all those things come with a lower acidic value. When the acidic value is higher, alkaline, you get more alkaline water, food. So all this improves the pH value. Time to laugh! throw the ball.
Is there
Who is the ball throw the ball. Name anybody who has not spoken before. Good, you choose a neighbor, that's good. Okay, laughter benefit.
Laughter connects us together.
Laughter is good connection. Connects us together. Let's connect. Let's get connected with laughter.
Laughter is contagious.
Laughter is contagious. Be a carrier.
Be a carrier of that. So let's convert the pandemic into happydemic with laughter. Okay, we have 10 minutes of break.
Yeah.
Toilet, warm water. E-coffee is available, but preferable is water and juice. And then after 10 minutes, we'll have a dance and laugh session. And then we'll be selecting some laughter heroes and heroines. So please, after 10 minutes, we'll start the
game. We have some prizes also in this section. So there'll be judging you. And then we will have the prize.
Dance is always done in a standing posture. Come to the standing portion. You are fully energized. Show your energies with laugh and dance.
Laugh and dance. One, two, three, four. Yes,
wow. After say namaskar to each other and laugh. Time to laugh.
Last man, let me enter there.
Start your day with smiles and yawning and laughing. Dancing mess will get the prize. The one who is dancing well keeps getting the prize.
In the mirror is the most beautiful creature of Almighty. Feel nice, feel good after looking at the face.
Look at the mirror and laugh. Keep spreading.
Time to laugh.
We have sometimes arguments. Resolve your arguments with laughter.
Resolve your arguments with laughter.
Which you are going to post on your Facebook this evening.
Take a selfie of yourself in love. Take a selfie in
Lion,
doctor, take your tongue out and pause. Keep distance. This video is going to be live, so keep distance. Keep distance.
King or laughter.
You are the laughter king. High five.
Credit card bill and
whenever you look at the credit card, laugh. Credit card bill. Credit card bill. The bill is there. Come laugh. पत्नी ने इतना खर्चा कर दिया था इतना लंबा बिल हो गया हां
दिन रात खर्चा करके आते हैं दिन
रात है ना लास्ट एंड द लॉर्डेस्ट लाफ्टर ऑफ द इवनिंग
लास्ट And the loudest.
For the Morano family and extended family, energetic family, youngsters family all around. Laugh.
So we'll have some prizes. Prize, all of you have become laughter king or laughter queen because you did so well. So each one of you gets a prize. So we'll start from the back side. Yes, the gentleman in the red, please come and accept your prize. Wow, wow. But you have to laugh.
Laugh.
Thank you. Next person. Thank you. Laughingly. Okay, next.
Wow.
Next. Okay, come. Okay,
come.
Okay, Anthony, my 71 years old young man. 71 years old. 71, laugh. Okay.
Any info there?
Just take that for the picture. Yes.
How many people find it?
Excellent. Good.
Okay. Laughter and clapping.
I want to tell you that it's his happy birthday and he keeps growing stronger and younger.
So
bless him today, please.
So you can stand.
Combined birthday, so
Miss Mariam
also, and this birthday.
Is her birthday?
Tomorrow. Okay. Anybody has
any
today?
Any proof required? Any proof required? If no proof required,
Yesterday my birthday day.
Yesterday, please come. Yeah, 3 days are covered. Yesterday, today and tomorrow. Anybody between yesterday, today and tomorrow?
Yes, mine in this year.
Okay, the birthday cake says laugh. And laugh. So let's laugh.
Three people.
We always start from yesterday. Please give a big laughter.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
here, stand there. Not so close.
COVID rules.
Okay. It is your turn.
Okay.
Congratulations. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
Many, many thanks.
Love, love, love. And best thing, Al Morena Group of Company and my builder, Mr. Sumit Suneja. Really big hand and big, big. So really, this program is amazing program, and too much relief, too much thinking, so much. This one, yoga and water and therapy, and Mr. Anthony, big hand Mr. Anthony. He's giving in natural. So really, thank you very much. Good enjoying.
Now this is to announce that his birthday, Mr. Pamnani's birthday, will be celebrated in the same place with all the people present, whenever it is. Next year.
Yes, okay. Okay, thank you for your participation. Please enjoy a simple, healthy food. We have kept it very simple as per our teachings. So don't expect any chicken, biryani, mutton or those things. It's a simple, healthy food as per the teaching. And be mindful while eating. As we said, chew your food so well that drink your solids and eat your liquids. And live 120 years again.
Repeat your message.
120 years definitely if you follow the naturopaths. So follow it, very simple, very, very simple. Follow the naturopathy, and I guarantee you 120 years living happily in this short journey of our life. Thank you so much.
Now speak Sharin, give a thank you, Morena Elliptical Sharin. Thank you.
Happy birthday, and I wish you a very healthy, prosperous, happy year and successful year.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Please bless Mr. Suneja. He should keep laughing always.
Yes. Okay, please enjoy your food. Please.